Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about neonatal adrenal hemorrhage imaging. Terminology: perinatal bleeding into normal adrenal gland associated with many perinatal stressors, asphyxia, sepsis, birth trauma, coagulopathy, increased frequency in full term and large infant. Most common signs symptoms: anemia, dropping hematocrit, jaundice, adrenal insufficiency, or hyperperformance in perinatal period. Other signs symptoms: occasionally discovered incident early during workup of unrelated antenatal hydronephrosis, unrelated abdominal pain in older child, incidental paraspinal calcification from a remote hemorrhage. Clinical profile: occur more often in full-term infant, macrosomy large for gestational age, baby, perinatal asphyxia. Demographic: age, newborn infant, sex, no sex predilection. Ethnicity, no racial predilection. Epidemiology, 1 to 2 per 1,000 births. Top differential analysis, neuroblastoma, congenital abdominal hyperplasia, extralobar bronchial pulmonary sequestration. Imaging, on right, more than left, bilateral in 5 to 10%. Ultrasound, echogenic avascular mass replacing or expanding newborn adrenal gland. Apparent vary with timing of imaging. Acute hemorrhage appear echogenic and masked wide. Subacute blood product liquefy and contrast creating mixed echogenic settings. Chronic adrenal resume normal signs plus minus calcification outsides. CT NMR, non-enhancing plus minus serine enhancing adrenal. MR measure high G1 signal intensity and or blooming on GOE depending on age of blood product. Radiograph, month to years later, small unilateral or bilateral adrenal calcification. This is the ultrasound image in a 13-day-old with multiple medical problems, so a large heterogeneous collection in the right adrenal with intermixed isoechoic and hypo to anechoic region. The adrenal is almost as large as the right kidney, which is duplicated. Doppler ultrasound in a neonate with subacute liquefying adrenal hemorrhage shows an absence of blood flow in the lesion, with no more perfusion of the adjacent kidney and spleen. Contrast intensity in an elementary school age patient shows adreniform calcification bilaterally, likely due to remote neonatal adrenal hemorrhage. T2FS MR in a 20-day-old with left prenatal hydronephrosis, so a heterogeneous right suprarenal mass deforming the right kidney. The mass was T1 bring with a few pussy blooming on GRE, serial ultrasound image show progressive decrease in size of mass over next 5 weeks. Child radiograph in a 3-year-old with cerebral palsy, so bilateral adrenal calcification. The long-term sequela of neonatal hemorrhage due to neonatostasis. Treatment. Observation is mostly adrenal insufficiency is extremely rare, require damage to more than 90% of adrenal tissue. Medical therapy may be required transiently. Exogenous steroid support of hypotension. Case report of adrenal abscess formation. Thank you.